गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट आर द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन फिजिकल एडसॉर्प्शन एंड केमिकल एडसॉर्प्शन. दैट मीन्स डिपेंडिंग अपॉन फोर्सेस ऑपरेटिंग बिटवीन एडजॉर्बेंट एंड एडजॉर्बेट एडसॉर्प्शन क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू टाइप्स. फर्स्ट वन इज फिजिकल एडसॉर्प्शन, सेकंड वन इज केमिकल एडसॉर्प्शन. फर्स्ट डिफरेंस इज डेफिनेशन. दैट मीन्स इफ द एडजॉर्बेट ईज हेल्ड ऑन ए सर्फेस ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट बै वीक वान डर वाल फोर्सेस दट टाइप ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन इज कॉल्ड फिजिकल एडजॉर्प्शन. दैट मीन्स द फोर्सेस ऑपरेटिंग बिटवीन एडजॉर्बेट एंड एडजॉर्बेंट ईज वीक वान डर वाल फोर्सेस सच टाइप ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन इज कॉल्ड फिजिकल एडजॉर्प्शन. दैट मीन्स फिजिकल एडसॉर्प्शन एराइजेस ड्यू टू वान डर वाल फोर्सेस. अकॉर्डिंग टू केमिकल एडसॉर्प्शन इफ द एडजॉर्बेट ईज हेल्ड ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट बै स्ट्रांग केमिकल बॉन्ड्स सच टाइप ऑफ एडसॉर्प्शन इज कॉल्ड केमिकल एडसॉर्प्शन. दैट मीन्स केमिकल एडसॉर्प्शन कॉज्ड ड्यू टू द chemical bond formation between adsorbent and adsorbent. That means the forces are strong chemical bonds between adsorbent and adsorbent in the case of chemical adsorption. Examples for physical adsorption is hydrogen oxygen gases are physically adsorbed on animal charcoal. Example for chemical adsorption is hydrogen gas is chemically bonded with nickel surface. That means hydrogen gas adsorption of hydrogen on nickel surface is example for chemisorption. It is the second difference. Now, third difference is physical adsorption, it is not specific in nature. That means any adsorbent does not cause special interaction on adsorption of adsorbent. But in the case of chemical adsorption, it is highly specific in nature. That means some metal surfaces adsorb only particular type of gases. That means it is highly specific in nature. That means in the formation of metal oxides, oxygen gas is absorbed on metal surface. In the formation of metal hydrides, hydrogen gas is absorbed on particular type of metal. That means chemical adsorption is highly specific in nature. This is the fourth difference. Next, fifth difference is physical adsorption is reversible in nature. That means adsorbent plus adsorbate is equilibrium with adsorption. That means forward reaction, backward reaction. Adsorbate plus adsorbent gives adsorption, physical adsorption. Physical adsorption breaks into adsorbate plus adsorbent. That is reversible in nature. But chemical adsorption is always irreversible in nature. Next, fourth difference is physical adsorption depends on the nature of gases. That means easily liquible gases. For example, hydrochloric acid and sulfur dioxide are adsorbed readily or physically adsorbed on adsorbent. That means easily liquible gases undergo physical adsorption. Chemical adsorption, it also depends on the nature of a gas which can react with adsorbent to show chemical reaction. So chemisorption, that means particular type of gases react with particular surface of adsorbent that show chemisorption. In the case of physical adsorption, enthalpy of adsorption is low. That value is equal to 20 to 40 kilojoules Molar numbers. That means in the formation of physical adsorption, it is an exothermic reaction. The heat energy is evolved in the case of physical adsorption is very low. That value that is equal to 20 to 40 kilojoules molar numbers. But in the case of chemisorption, enthalpy of adsorption is very high. That value is equal to 80 to 240 kilojoules molar numbers. That means adsorption is always exothermic reaction. So that means heat evolved in the case of chemisorption is very high. That values are equal to 80 to 240 kilojoules molar numbers. Next difference is physical adsorption is favorable at low temperatures. That means physical adsorption decreases with increase of temperature. That means low temperature is the favorable condition for formation of physical adsorption. Physical adsorption decreases with increase of temperature. But in the case of chemisorption, high temperature is the favorable condition for chemisorption. That means chemisorption or chemical adsorption increases with increase in the temperature. Next difference is no appreciable activation energy is needed in the case of physical adsorption, but high activation energy is sometimes needed. That means activation energy is very high in the case of chemical adsorption. Activation energy does not play important role in the case of physical adsorption. Both are depending upon surface area of adsorbent. That means physical adsorption as well as chemical adsorption depends on the surface area of the adsorbent. That means surface area of the adsorbent increases, both physical adsorption and chemical adsorption also increases. Next, in the formation of physical adsorption, it results into multi-molecular layers on adsorbent surface under high pressure. That means pressure increases, adsorbate formed multi-layers on the surface of adsorbent. But in the case of chemical adsorption, it results into unimolecular layer only. That means adsorbate chemically adsorbed on only unimolecular layers. These are the differences between physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. Okay.